Welcome back. Someone once said that our thoughts lead to actions. Actions lead to habits, and habits form character. Character obviously leads to destiny. This clearly shows how important a role habits play in our daily lives, and I'm sure you already have a list of healthy habits that you want to inculcate in order to become a better version of yourself. Let's say you're someone who is not really happy with your eating habits because you just grabbed for that last bag of chips over the weekend or a bottle of cola while watching a movie and you want to change that. Or you're someone who's not happy with your sleeping habits. You want to be in bed by 10 p.m. so that you could wake up a little early. We all start off with a lot of enthusiasm, but over time, this excitement, enthusiasm, and motivation wanes off. It generally takes a minimum of 21 consecutive days of practice to formulate a habit. This may sound very simple, but I'm not surprised to see how few people actually stay committed to this routine. So now the question is, how do you stick to something for 21 days until it becomes a habit and then continue it over the long term? Because come on, everyone who starts a new habit wants to stick with it over the long term. That's why in today's video, I will be helping you set up a system in order to achieve just that using habit trackers. Please note that this is not something that I have invented or anything of that sort. You could go on Google, type in habit trackers, and click on the images tab to see how many types of trackers are out there already. I am just going to share one such tracker that worked for me like magic. Let me start by telling you how I ended up with it in the first place. Here is my 2020 bullet journal or bujo where I've tried quite a few trackers. This one is a habit tracker with icons representing each habit and the days of the month on the left side, a mood tracker and a sleep tracker on this page. Here is another tracker, a habit tracker, that I obviously printed out from the web. Over time, my priorities changed as I have two little kids under the age of 5. And I started finding it difficult to dedicate a set amount of time every single night to fill all these up. So that's when I thought, what would be the one thing that I want to take out of this bullet journal and change it in a way such that it becomes simple, quick, and beneficial? That's how my habit tracker was born. You will need a paper, a ruler, a pencil or a pen, and a few optional markers. Basically, we are going to draw a big table with 31 columns and quite a few rows for listing down our habits, like so. Now that the structure is ready, let us get to the fun part. Write down the column headings, habits and numbers from 1 to 31 signifying each day of the month. Go ahead, be brave and list down all the habits including the tiny ones like soaking dry fruits or brushing your teeth before going to bed, etc. Here are the habits that I am going to track in February. Some simple ones like 8 hours of sleep, waking up by 6 a.m., warm water, oil pulling and tough ones like workout, in my case that's yoga or pranayama, mantra meditation, and some others are taking nuts or vitamins, practicing gratitude, career-related reading, YouTube and Instagram, content creation, kids activities and story time, 8 glasses of water every single day, brushing at night before going to bed, and reading. And ta-da! Habit tracker is all set. It's as simple as that. How to use this tracker? I usually fill it up towards the end of the day. The most important point here is to stick it in a place where you get to see it multiple times in a single day, because it not only serves as a visual clue but also as a reminder to catch up with your habits. I have mine on my fridge because come on, there's no way I can miss this spot, be it a weekend or a weekday. Let's say today is the 1st of February. Go through each habit and color or mark the boxes that you were able to accomplish today. Continue doing it every single day until you reach the end of the month. It only takes 2 to 5 minutes each day, and here's how your trackers might look towards the end of the month. You could keep it very minimal or go an extra mile, making it as colorful as these ones here. The analysis. What good is a system if we cannot get feedback and improve based on it? Just by looking, it is evident that I was able to stick with warm water, oil pulling, mantra meditation, reading, etc. But habits like workout, sleep cycle, eating nuts, clearly I need to be more regular because there are very few boxes that are colored. Based on this feedback, I can do one of these three things. Simplest way is to consciously make an effort to stick to the habit. Second one is to link these habits to rewards. Like if I wake up at 6 a.m. every single day without hitting snooze, then I will let myself sleep until 8 a.m. on Sundays. The third one is to start small. Like instead of one hard workouts, I will concentrate on completing just 5 sets of Surya Namaskara to begin with throughout the next month. Building consistency is the key when it comes to habits. The benefits. By tracking your progress, you could really motivate yourself to keep pushing forward. You could also go ahead with any of the habit tracking apps out there. But if you ask me, these apps can sometimes feel a bit overwhelming, especially the streak part. The motto of having a streak is to motivate us, but personally, I feel it works the other way around for many, because if you just don't do it for one day, the whole streak is gone. Or if you do it for a few months at a stretch, then the huge numbers on the streak can be scary as well. So I prefer the old school way, the analog method of doing things with pen and paper, as I've been showing you all this while. Here are a few advantages of my habit tracker. It is completely customizable, easy to use, no gadgets required, no additional screen time, hence no strain to eyes, not overwhelming as we are just going to track for 1 month at a time. You can make adjustments by revisiting and redefining your habits at the beginning of every single month. Consider yourself even more lucky if you have access to a printer. Because guess what? I went ahead and created a printable version of my habit tracker. The link to download it is in the description box. Go ahead, print it, and get on with tracking your habits for the month of February. I guess that's all I have for today. Let me know in the comments section if you found this video helpful, and if you end up making one of your own habit trackers, then don't forget to share it on Instagram and tag me at chandana.chaitanya. If you're curious, then here are the 6 healthy habits I inculcated in 2020 successfully with the help of this very habit tracker. With that, this is Chandana signing off. Stay happy and healthy. Talk to you all soon.